friends, I'm Rosa. Welcome. So, today we're talking December TBR because December is literally for me right now as of recording 3 days away. This might go up sometime in December. I don't know yet. Kind of trying to pre-record a little bit because I want to do plenty of stuff on the channel throughout December. We got a lot of wrapping up to do. So, for December, just like I did last year, I've decided to join a readathon. It's called the Reindeer Readathon. I think at the moment you can't sign up anymore, but that doesn't mean you still can't like follow the prompts and stuff. Basically, I had to choose 9 books to fit with the prompts, and then there's like 5 extra bonus prompts that have to fit with those 9 previous ones, if that makes sense. So I have my notebook to make sure that I don't mess up which book is for which prompt. I also have my phone so that I have access to the description of the different prompts. Yes, if you don't know readathons, it's basically like you get prompts. So say read a book that includes the letter A or something like that, and then you do several different prompts throughout the month, and usually there's like a point system and stuff. So there's 5 teams for the Reindeer Readathon. I am on the Nutcracker team. Last year I was on the Candy Cane team. So if there are any fellow Nutcrackers out there, hello. I'll do my best to actually contribute, okay? The problem with readathons, especially if there's like a competition aspect to it, is that I am super competitive and it's so annoying. So anyway, let's get started though, shall we? Because we got 9 books to go through. So prompt 1 was Dasher. And the description says, read a book where the title contains one of the first 5 words you see in a word grid down further on the page. Must be a word from the list. So the word that I found was book, or I found like more words, but I decided to stick with book. Because I've actually taken this off my shelves recently, I got the number for it, unwrapped it, and I got The Book Thief by Marcus Zusak, which includes the word the book. And I've always had this feeling that this is like a perfect winter read, not necessarily like a December read, but definitely a winter one. I don't really know why. I cannot tell you why. All I know about this book is that it takes place during the Second World War. We follow Death and a little girl who I think thieves books, and that it's hugely loved, very heavy on the historical fiction, but does have a fantasy aspect to it. 1939, Nazi Germany, the country is holding its breath. Death has never been busier. Yes. Oh, her parents have been taken away to a concentration camp. And she steals books. So it's about her, and I'm guessing this neighborhood as well, maybe. She's living with a foster family on Himmel Street. Was this ever turned into a movie? Anyway, so this is the book that I'm choosing for the Dasher prompt. This also counts as one of the bonus prompts because one of them was read a book that is more than 500 pages, which this one is 517, seemingly. So it counts. So we got book 1. I can't place them here because there's not going to be room for them anyway. The next prompt is called Dancer, and it says read a book with a title that has at least 5 words in it. So my book club and myself decided that we're gonna read The Bear and the Nightingale by Katherine Arden as the secondary pick for December. And it happens to have 5 words in the title. Yes, I was very insistent on somehow fitting in the 2 book club picks into this readathon, just so I wouldn't have to add them on top, because December is a very, very busy month. So I'm gonna be reading this as part of the readathon, but I'll be reading this throughout. Oh, this is signed very nicely. I'll be reading this throughout the month of December, so it won't be like a in one setting thing. Very excited for this. I think it's young adult fantasy with maybe like a hint of historical fiction to it as well. I don't really fully know. There's also no synopsis in this edition, by the way, because it's a Lumicrate, so I can't really tell you what it's about because I also cannot remember. But I'm very, very excited for it. Also because this is definitely giving winter vibes, if you get what I'm like, look at it. Look at it, but also I just, winter vibes. The original cover as well has winter vibes. I think, is it Russian as well? That there's like, maybe it's not Russian, but it draws inspiration from somewhere over east. So whether it's Eastern Europe or Russia, I can't fully exactly remember. But I'm very excited because it's like a little bit of like a YA classic, you know? Not don't take that words like literally. I just feel like it's like a very well-known YA book. So I'm very excited to be reading this with them. Oh, and as always, if you want to check out the book club, there's a link to it in the pinned comment. Oh, and also, I'll actually not be reading that edition of it. I will be reading it on my iPad, so that means that it also counts for one of the bonus prompts because it is that you have to read an ebook. So we got that checked off the list. Anyway, the third prompt is Prancer, and it says, read a book set in a place you have never been. And that is such an easy prompt when you read majorly fantasy books, but also a lot of my books don't take place in places that I've been to in the US or the UK, and if they take place in like an actual place in the world, it's usually those two places. So it's not that I'm not well traveled, because I believe that I am. Not to an extreme, but like, I've been a lot of places. However, it's very easy to find like a book from like a little place somewhere that takes place in like a small place somewhere in England or a small place somewhere in the US. So I found out that I needed to, you know, some kind of Christmas holiday romance book in my December TBR. We have Lovelight Farms by BK Borison. I don't actually know where this takes place. It just says Christmas Tree Farm. A small town with the best hazelnut lattes on the East Coast. I have not been to a small town on the East Coast, which I'm guessing is the US. I'm just saying, we also have an East Coast. But never been to a small town on the East Coast. So I am just assuming that this is gonna be fine. I am just going out on a limb and saying that I've not been there. The only city I've been to on the East Coast is New York, and I wouldn't call it a small town. So, Lovelight Farms. That's like a little quick. A handsome, freckled data analyst, a messy, optimistic Christmas tree farm owner. A small town with the best hazelnut lattes on the East Coast. In an effort to save the Christmas tree farm she's loved since she was a child, Stella enters a contest with Insta-famous influencer Evelyn St. James. With the added publicity and the huge cash prize, she might just be able to save the farm from its financial woes. There's just one problem. To make the farm seem like a romantic destination for the holidays, she lied on the application and said that she owns Lovelight Farms with her boyfriend. Only there is no boyfriend. Enter best friend Luca Peters. He just came home for some hot chocolate and somehow got a farm and a serious relationship in the process. Will their fake love affair save Lovelight Farms in time for Christmas? It sounds a bit like a Hallmark movie, like I'm not gonna lie. I'm here for the vibes. I'm looking forward to it. So, Lovelight Farms. This one kind of sucks because I also had it on my last, on my November TBR, but it fits because you'll see why in a second. It's called Vixen, and the prompt is, read a book you have been putting off. So fittingly, I decided to add Nevernight from November TBR, which I never got to start. I've been very busy throughout November, and I really desperately want to read this. I just kind of keep putting it off because I'm nervous that I won't like it. I'm really hoping that I will. So this is Nevernight by J. Kristoff. I think possibly adult, but it could also be YA, but I think knowing J. Kristoff and the way that he writes, I don't know. It could go either way. Like, I don't really know. He tends to swear a lot. He's very graphic in his language. So, you know, we have that. And other than that, I don't really fully know what this is about other than her name's Mia and she is at an assassin's school. Something about having taken revenge on people who killed her father. Oh, and people start to get killed at the school. Seemingly. Maybe. We'll see. I'm excited though. Also, she looks like a badass. So, it's like, look at this. Pretty cool, if I may say so. So yeah, I have high hopes, but I'm a little bit nervous about it. But yeah, fantasy. Definitely fantasy. I have all three books as well as hardcovers, which is another reason that I'm very nervous. But that's my own fault if I don't like it. I bought those fully knowing that that's on me. That's a risk that I'm willing to take. Oh, and that one also counts for one of the bonus prompts, which is called Christmas Elf, which is a book that has been on your shelf/TBR for a long time, because I think I bought those back in 2021. I probably have books that I've had for longer than that, but we're going with it, okay? We're going with it. As for prompt number 5, we have Comet. Read a book that starts with the same letter as your star sign. Says L for Leo, V for Virgo, and my star sign is, my zodiac sign is Aquarius, so that has to start with A, which was perfect because the book club's primary pick for December is Assistant to the Villain by Hannah Nicole Mara, which I'm still not fully certain what it's about, to be honest, other than we follow the assistant to the villain and it's a romance story, so I'm kind of like, I don't really need to know more than that. People are very much loving this. Fantasy romance, by the way. Would you call this romantasy then? I suppose. One job, don't fall for the boss, who's also the villain. And I just, everyone loved this when it just came out, so I have kind of high hopes for it, but also, I don't know, I just want to know what the hype is about. You get what I mean? Like, I'm curious, but I don't want to know too much about the synopsis before going into it. So, I want to unpack it while I read it, you know what I mean? But people seem to think that it was really, really funny, so I suggested this to the book club. They were all for it, so that is our primary pick. And I'm very, very excited. For prompt number 6, it says, Cupid, read a book that has multiple points of view. And that is super easy, I have so many. But because I'm also trying to finish up some series, I decided to go for The Rebel King by Kennedy Ryan, which is the sequel to The Kingmaker, which ended on a cliffhanger. So mean. So rude. And so this follows both of our lead characters, Maxim and Lennox, and so that means we have two points of views, and I am so excited. I liked The Kingmaker because it felt a little bit more, it's a romance, but it felt a little bit more mature, but you also follow the characters throughout the years, so you kind of like follow their journey from when they meet each other and are really, really drawn to each other, and then when they meet each other like now and then, and when things start to go bad and stuff, and you know. Definitely slightly giving, not mafia vibes because it's not about the mafia, but there's something about Maxim's father that just, there's a vibe. You get what I mean? Like, he's definitely not a good guy. And so Maxim does have a little bit of that, but he's definitely a better guy, even though his motivations are a little bit questionable at times. So yes, we do have a little bit of that. And also badass girl, like, yes. Or woman, I should say, because she's older than me, so she's a woman. Badass woman. So, I'm excited for this. I am very excited to see what, anyway. Like I said, cliffhanger at the end of the first one. You kind of read through the first one thinking that the pacing, if you're not really, like, keeping in mind that it is a duology, the pacing is very different from other romance books, so definitely keep that in mind. But, very, very excited to see, because, like, cliffhangers, just mean one. So super excited for The Rebel King, adult romance, just want to say. And then we have, this one is kind of like, I struggled so much finding a book that fit this prompt, which is so stupid because it definitely should not be a struggle, but like, it, trust me, I struggled so hard. The prompt is, Donner, read a book with multiple animals on the cover. And you would think, yeah, that's easy. You have so many covers with animals on them. Ignore Iron Flame, because I don't want to read that in December. And I consider dragons animals, technically. Okay. At some point I was like, what if there's just two humans on it? Because technically we're animals too. I was really like out trying to twist it. What I came up with though is like a little bit of a workaround, but you know how covers often are different in the UK and the US. So also to not start another series, but to try and continue the ones that I'm already reading, I decided Exodus, you can tell, no animals, but the original cover has several birds on it. So I found so many covers in my collection with one bird on it or on them. My gosh. And I was like, the Raven Boys, that's perfect. And then I accidentally picked up The Dream Thieves, which has several birds on it. I was like, yes, perfect. And then I noticed the title wasn't The Raven Boys. The Raven Boys only has one raven on it. So, The Dream Thieves, though, has several. So this book, the original cover, has several ravens on it. I checked, I triple checked. It better have them still. Like, if they've disappeared overnight, I'm gonna be very, very disappointed. But while this cover might not, it has like one wing on it and like, I don't know, like a fake bird, the original does. So I'm reading the sequel to Flock by Kate Stewart. Yes. And Flock is like, it's about a girl who has to, again, it's like a new adult romance, but it's about a girl who has to go back to, or not back, because she's never been there before, but her parents are divorced. For some reason, she can't really be with her mother over the summer, so she makes a deal with her father, who's basically not really been there, to basically stay at his house over the summer. And then she also has to work for him. But again, he's not really fathering, if you will. So she's kind of left to her own devices a little bit. She ends up making friends with some guys who hang out a lot, and things start to evolve with two of them, which is very interesting. And there's a bit of like a Robin Hood aspect to it as well, which I think I can say without it being a spoiler, because I'm pretty sure that it's actually mentioned on the book. So, but like, you can put two and two together, figure out there's something going on with these boys, okay? With these guys. So, yes. And that also kind of ended on a cliffhanger, and I'm very, very curious to see where it's gonna go. Really, actually really enjoyed it. It was kind of a little bit repetitive at times, I will say, but overall I like the vibe of it, so I'm very excited to go into the sequel, Exodus, and it's happening in December. This is also over 500 pages. That could have counted at that, as that as well. Or is it? Hold on. No, 507! I managed to do that without actually spoiling anything. So impressed with myself. You know when you want to check how many pages a book is and then you accidentally read like a couple of lines on the last pages? I hate when that happens. But like, my eyes just go too quickly. Like, I can't control it. They just move too quickly and I'm like, oh, shoot, I saw that. Yeah, that didn't happen this time. Okay, and then we have Blitzen, which was a funky one. So the Blitzen prompt was roll a dice or use a number generator 1 to 6. The number you get multiplied by 100 is the minimum amount of pages the book needs to have, and I rolled 5. And so I decided to go with another book that I've either had on like a recent TBR list or the November one, which is also recent, but like either November or October, September. But it also fits with one of the bonus prompts, which is The Poppy War by R.F. Kuang. This is also one of the 23 for 2023 that I have to read, so like, I really want this to fit in here. But I'm just so nervous going into it. It's over 500 pages, and it's historical fiction. There is fantasy in it, but it's the historical fiction aspect of it that I am nervous about, because I don't do well with too much historical fiction. I just kind of, I need there to be like lots of fantasy in it, you get what I mean? I don't know, it's hard to explain. It just doesn't catch me the same way. But this also fit with a bonus prompt that was Christmas Tree, which says branch out and read a book you wouldn't typically go for, which I think The Poppy War being a very adult historical fantasy, mature seemingly, but also the historical fiction aspect to it, wouldn't necessarily be one that I go for a lot. I read a lot of romanticism these days, and romance, and fantasy. Not so much this. So I feel like it counts. I feel like this is out of my comfort zone, actually, which is why, or how I understand that prompt. And so we follow Ren, who is at an academy training to be a soldier or something. Fighting the prejudice of rival classmates because she's a dark-skinned peasant girl. Ren discovers that she possesses a lethal unearthly power, an aptitude for the nearly mythical art of shamanism, which is sounds very, very cool. Exploring her gift with the help of a seemingly insane teacher, Rin learns that gods long thought dead are very much alive, and the mastering these powers could mean more than just surviving school. So I think this is, well, magic school is one of the prompts that I'm missing from one of the challenges that I'm doing throughout this, or I have been doing throughout this year as well, so it's gonna count towards that as well. Nevernight could technically. So yes, but yeah, lots of historical fiction in this with the Poppy War title. I feel like that's very obvious. But I'm very excited nonetheless, just nervous to go into it. So, but I'm giving it a try. I'm gonna do my best, okay? And that leaves us with the last one, which is actually an arc I got recently, because the last prompt was Rudolph, and the description is read a book that came out before you were born, or a book that came out in 2023. I don't own a lot of books that were born before I was born. I suppose technically correct. I don't own a lot of books that were written before I was born, so I decided to go with one that came out in 2023. I have a lot of arcs that I've not gone through yet, and decided to pick one off the list that I think is gonna be a fun, quick read, which is Vengeance of the Pirate Queen by Trisha Levensellers. Or actually, let's put the cover up here. But it's the third one in her, what's the series called? It's like Daughter of the Pirate King and then Daughter of the Siren Queen. So she has written a new one. I think it doesn't follow Alosa, is that her name? The redheaded girl from the two first books. I think it follows one of her friends, but Vengeance of the Pirate Queen. And I don't really know how much I can say about the synopsis and stuff because it's the third book, but the first two were so much fun. Like, just super fast-paced, action-filled, enemies to lovers as well, with a badass female lead character. Like YA fantasy, but not so much pirates, so not so much like a lot of like magic fantasy, you know what I mean? But a little bit of that as well. Just like a tiny bit. She is the daughter of the Siren Queen after all. But it was just kind of cool. I really liked it. I enjoyed them. I thought they were like classic YA, so just fun, a good time, and doesn't require way too much like thought put into it. You can just like breeze through it as well and just have a good time with it. So for that purpose, they served, and so I'm hoping that the new one will kind of do the same as well for me, but we will see. So, but that was the 2023 book. I have a lot I could have picked, actually, or picked between, because I have so many arcs that I've not touched yet, and that's so dumb, but that's fully on me for being slow at reading my arcs. But that one also counts as my last bonus, which I have had to change from an audiobook to an ebook because I generally don't really have access to a lot of audiobooks and I generally suck at listening to them. So if I pick one of the ones that the selection would have been very small and I can't do like long audiobooks. Speaking of the November TBR, Outlander, for example, the audiobook is like 35 hours long or something, and I can only listen to an hour a day and I go crazy, so, or just lose focus. And so it's been returned, but I put a hold on it again. So hopefully I'll get it back and I can actually finish the book. We will see. So I decided to change the ebook to, or the audiobook to another ebook instead. And that one counts for that bonus prompt as well. So those were my books. As for the very last prompt, we'll see if I get to it. So far I have nothing for it, but I'll figure it out if I get to it, because it's a big if. But those were the books. If you want to check them out, I will be leaving links to them in the description box down below. And I think that is all. So expect lots of content up here during December. I am so excited to share all the wrap-ups with you because we got a lot to go through. There will be a ranking video as well. I hope to reorganize my shelves as well, do another book shelf tour as well. There'll be lots of unboxings too. We have plenty to do here in December, so I hope you guys are ready for it. But if you enjoyed this video, feel free to hit the thumbs up, and if you want to see more videos like this from me and all the other stuff that I just mentioned, feel free to stick around by clicking on the subscribe button. However, I'm gonna leave you to it, so hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye bye. Oh, you know, you're beautiful.